Well, howdy, folks. I know it's late, but I just had to do this. I got two questions today, or yesterday and today, but basically the same questions about the same topic. And it was about expanding, but ultimately it was around the fact that when you have more than one cart, and or if you just have one cart, because we have people that get in that never have any intention of running the cart, they'll hire people to run the cart. And when you do that, what happens if you lease your cart out and they don't return it when they're supposed to? And that question, and then we got another question. Let me see if I can pull that up in the comments that said, how do you suggest I keep track of inventory? This is from Timothy Johnson. Thanks for the question, Timothy. Should I tell them to throw the hot dogs that they didn't use in a plastic bag or something? That way you can count them, you know. And let me tell you what a little about how you get there. I made a huge mistake. I ended up making it through it, or several mistakes, but in those mistakes, any of those could have been disastrous for my business. And so when I first started, you know, and it started taking off, and by week seven, I had three carts. I had gotten three. Well, I just kept that ball moving. And so by the end of a full year, I had 22 carts, which was insane. Okay. Because first of all, I still didn't have all this down. And two, I was managing carts under different plans. And what I'm talking about is I had some that were employees, some where they leased the cart, but they got the food through me, some where they got their own food and I leased the cart in the location, some just the cart. So I had so many plans going, I was rattled because I was trying different methods to figure out. Plus, if I had somebody that didn't like this, I'd create a method for them, you know. Oh, let me help you. Let's do it this way. And I'd create, it was maddening. It was completely maddening. And then you have these other issues. You have liability issues or at least risk that you've put out these extra carts, right? And then you don't know for sure where are they coming back? And what do I do if they don't come back? So let's answer that first one. What if they keep your cart in a lease? Well, first of all, if you protect yourself correctly, it's really easy. It'd be like if you go to the tool rental place. And, you know, Lowe's and Home Depot now rent tools, but, you know, your local tool rental company, we have one called A&A Rental, and then we have Severe Rental. But if you go to one of these companies and you rent a tool and you don't come back, they get a warrant for your arrest within hours of you not doing it, returning it. Why? Because you signed paperwork that gave them authority to take those state attorneys and forego any hearings. Let's just go get him. He kept my drill press or whatever, you know. So you can protect yourself with the right kind of paperwork. So you want to make sure that you get the right kind of paperwork for your state that abides by your state laws, even if you use a generic one. Just a little bit of a hint is you can just go to a rental company that's local to you online or one in your state and borrow their rental agreement, which will protect them nine ways to Sunday, okay? And check their rental agreement and then manipulate it, edit it down to where it fits what you're doing. That's one way. But who's to say that the lease is the best thing, right? What about a subcontractor? What about a profit sharing contractor? There's so many ways to do this that protect you. And what I have found in life, period, not just with hot dog vendors, the more you give ownership to other people, the people that are to us, the people that are type A personalities, they will give more than they ever would anywhere else because they're taking ownership. It's kind of like if I tell my, my 4-year-old that I need him to clean the fish tank. You know, my grandson, I say, clean the fish tank. And he half clean it. But when I told him, I was giving him one of the fish in the tank and we got to keep it real clean. Oh, spotless tank now because I ain't cleaning it for Papaw. I'm cleaning that tank for my fish. And so he took ownership. And that's the best example I can give you. I know that's more of a simplified example, but you're not going to fool a person, you know, but you're being honest with it. So it's not like you're manipulating them. You're being honest with them. So that's why I found more successfully to have a, good grief, I found it more successful to use profit sharing models, okay? And then I had paperwork for that. But then we get to Timothy's question about how do you keep track of inventory? Well, it depends. It depends on if you're providing inventory. But let's assume you are. If you're having to keep track of it, you're putting out inventory. Again, back to the ownership. If you're giving them ownership, you know, giving them some ownership in it, not necessarily the cart, their only ownership of the operation, where they get to take a portion of its proceeds instead of, oh, I'm getting $12 an hour. We've got vendors paying, this is no joke, $17 to $20 an hour just to run a cart. Those carts are in good locations, tested locations, working well, and so they want good employees, so they pay them well. And I found the same. I found the higher I paid them, the better quality I got out of them. Even if you took the same person and paid them $9 an hour, paid them $15 an hour, the $15 hour one will work like the best employee you ever saw. But the $9 one's like, Ben ain't gonna miss these hot dogs. I give them to my sister and stuff when they come by because, hell, I'm doing all the work. It's that mentality of, oh, he's getting rich off of my back, right? Probably not the right person you want in that position then. They need to go work at McDonald's or something. You need people that are going to represent you well, but I have found that given ownership. Now, I've put in the comments, and I should have put the link up here. Bear with me, I can put this in here real quick. Okay, I did a course. Oh, surprise. I did a course on expanding, and it's not just a course. It goes through the pros and cons of each way to do it, okay? And then I give you a summary of the best ways to do it, okay? The best ways to operate carts outside. Then I give you a little bonus one about a cart that I never saw, never touched, right? I mean, literally never saw, never touched, and made money off of it every month. And then on top of that, I give you all the paperwork. So that, and the paperwork will, it's general enough that it will apply in your state. Plus, it actually says in there, if any of this didn't apply, it only takes out that. It doesn't negate the rest of the contract. And you'll find that in all contracts nowadays, if lawyers written it. Well, we had a lawyer write these contracts up in a general sense so that you can use them. You can use them just as they are. If you need to take out something, take it out. If you need to edit it, you can. It gives you a good starting point. Now let me get over here to and say hi and also catch any questions I might have missed. Let's see, expanding my middle, LOL. Yeah, I do the same thing. I expand my middle today. I ate a piece of carrot cake. I swear it was this big. It's one of my favorites. City Dogs and Catering, how you doing? Flipping Franks and Catering. The Flying Bass, what do you think of my name? Cannonball Dogs and Catering. I like it. Anything that that's your start of your branding. You know, you're starting your branding. So anytime you can use something that's catchy, mo better gooda. All in all, Hot Dogs and Catering. Hi, Ben. Got my surf safe. We'll be able to finally legally vend. Congratulations. If a lot of you are wondering what the hell surf safe is, it's just a third-party company that some states require you to go through food safety class. And so usually it's 8 hours. Sometimes it's 3 days of 2 hours a day or 3 hours a day or something. But either way, it's over and it's done. And then you can, it depends on whether you want to be a food safety manager or food safety employee. Usually a state who has those rules will require you be a manager so that if you're going to have employees, they work under you as blah, blah, blah. Let's see, I need to turn that off. Okay, I have very specific set of skills learned over a lifetime. Awesome. All in all, catering. Hi, Ben, got my surf safe. I love that. Dragon wieners and catering in the house. Hey, Amanda. Busboy, Ben, I have a question about handling the money people give you, which I don't get that. I don't know. what that is. Then I have a question about handling the money people give you. Which hand do you use? Do you have... do you have to keep... I don't know why. That was just not going into my head. Which hand do you use? Do you have to keep taking your gloves on and off? That would be the hard and sweaty part. This is a good one for another time, but let me tell you real quick. I always had a glove on hand. I changed that anytime I had to touch something else. But one hand was gloved, the other hand wasn't. I took the money with the other hand, and if you've seen my training videos on that, and they're free at Learn Hot Dogs, I had three pockets in the front. So I had ones, fives, and tens. Anything bigger than that I received, it went in my back pocket. I made change out of there. So at any time, I had ones, fives, and tens, and I could reach in and change. I didn't like messing with change, so I never messed with change. I just messed with the ones, fives, and tens. I'm talking about coin change. The other thing is some vendors like to have both gloves on, and they like to handle money with both hands. That's doable too. And some vendors are taking and putting on a tight glove, a latex glove or similar, and then using the loose gloves that are like mittens that they hang off the cart, and you can stick your hand in them, rip off a pair, work, sling them off, and now you got your glove hand. And so you can keep doing that over and over, and you're always got good protective gloves on over it. And they look like mitts, and they're really big so that even with your other gloves on, it doesn't mess with anything. And that's another good way to do it. Let's see. Hey, Ben, it's Phyllis from Cali. I always miss you because of the time difference. Always good advice. Yeah, the time difference messes up. I'd have to go later or go way earlier. But thank you, Phyllis. Cheryl, hey, Ben, got your text. Glad you did, Cheryl. That's cool. Eric Von Dumb, told you I'd be here, Ben. I'm glad you're here. Eric Bugs, hey, from Boston Street Eats and Catering, Bugs Moran. Edward, Mikado's Smokehouse and Dogs, howdy. Let's see, thanks, working, getting my hot dog cart in a year or two, getting my ducks in a row. Thanks for all your help and advice. Flying Bass, you know what? I've had people just like you where they tell me I'm going to be starting in a year or two. And not all of them do. Okay, some of them find something else. Some of them win the lottery, whatever. But some of them do. And it's so cool to hear about the progress they make in between. And usually those people that have more time to get started, they do a lot more due diligence. And that due diligence pays off huge rewards when you're starting out and throughout the business. My gig is Hot Diggity Dogs. Looking forward to a busy weekend here in Eastern Arizona. Awesome, Cheryl. I hope you kick butt. Let's see. Hey, Ben from Hot Hounds Dogs Catering, soon to be opening Louisiana. Awesome. Danny Turner in the house. Nothing finer here. Life's full of funny signs. My elderly neighbor was asking my wife what I was building in the drive. She said hot dog wagon. He went into the house, came out with a copy of Hot Dog Save My Life. That's freaking awesome, Wes. John Russell, have a great Memorial Weekend vending. Awesome, awesome. Yep, I'm supposed to be Saturday live vending, weather permitting, with Packers Lemonade and the hot dog. He's going to have both setups going. I'm going to try to get you as much information and much stuff as you can. And I'll even try to set it up so you can ask questions live during it. Let's see. I'll probably be doing it all, though, through my phone. Okay, so it won't be as good because the comments on the phone, they go up for a minute and then they disappear. And then they go, some more come up and then they disappear before I can read them. It gives you like three at a time. I haven't figured out how to keep them steady. So what I'm also going to do is I'm going to set up one of my tripods. I'm going to try to do a 360 live. I'm also going to try to, I got a new camera, okay? And I'm going to try to film some real good high def 4K, bleh, good stuff, right? So I'm going to test that out as well. Doing my research for my Tennessee state codes. Too many big words. Let's see. Let's see. Did I miss you? Who did I miss? Oh, Danny Turner's there. Brad's on the go. To keep your buns dry this weekend, everyone. Absolutely, Frankenstein's. It could be a rainy weekend. They're calling for it, at least in Western North Carolina and Eastern Tennessee. Doing my research for my Tennessee state codes. There, you know what? Don't worry about the state codes. If you follow my instruction, you don't have to know the state codes. And Tennessee really is easy. Okay, so what you do is, I don't care where you're buying your cart, you take those schematics and you give them to the health department. Let them worry about telling you where it meets it and where it doesn't meet it. If you, let's say you have, you know, two, I don't know, donut machines in there that squirt hot grease up in the air and fall into another pot, and he goes, no, you can't have that. Let him be the one to tell you that. And that's before you bought. You didn't spend a dime. And that's how you do your due diligence, so that you at least narrow it down. He may look at a... I've never had any problems with any of our carts in Tennessee. Tennessee's just easy. You know, they're easy. They don't even require sinks. So you can go out there with no sinks, no cooler if you want. I wouldn't suggest it just because it looks crappy. But you can. I mean, even if your sink doesn't work, it's there. It's better. Going to be a weekly car show on Friday. Definitely going to take your advice and hire a cute female to take orders. Car guys love cute women. Absolutely. Ben, how long do you test out a location before you move on? It depends on the location. It does. Flipping Frank's and Catering, it depends on the location. I've been to a location as short as 7-8 days. Then I've been to locations where I tested out 2 to 3 weeks. Because I was so adamant on it working. Corey tested one out. Corey Lawrence with O'Doggies tested one out for months before he finally said, piss on this, this ain't working. It all depends on, one, your budget. Two, do you have a backup? Do you already have some backup so you can keep testing this one maybe every Tuesday and then do over here? But sometimes it's just a matter of placement at the location. Sometimes it's a matter of signs at the location. It may not be the location. Sometimes it's just a matter of the freaking spot. It's just some kind of weird anomaly. It doesn't work there. Ordering book next Friday, Social Security payday. Going to do this from Haines, Alaska. Failure to prepare is preparing to fail. Absolutely, Robert's retreat. Thanks. Send me an email, Robert. Send me an email, ben@learnhotdogs.com, please. You don't have to say anything, just send me an email. I want to connect with you. I just left from meeting a nightclub owner, trying the night shift this weekend to get some more biz. You will kick butt at an... Ooh, good. That is really good. And if you followed me, you know we have real vendors doing that, like, consistently. The dude in South Carolina got cancer, and he just, bam, bam, 3 nights a week, and he's getting paid to be there. And he gets to keep 100% of his profits. We got a lot of them doing that. And then the one I interviewed recently, what are they doing? They're doing a freaking club. They're doing a club 3 to 4 nights a week. That was that young couple. Y'all remember them? They were fixing to get a Stand King, I believe. And they're fixing to buy a house. I interviewed them, I don't know, maybe 3 weeks ago on here live. Or not live, but maybe I did do that one live. Not sure, but either way, it's here. I hope y'all have a freaking awesome evening. I love you, and I'll talk to you soon.